Hi, I'm Ryan Szymanski, curator for Battleship New Jersey Museum and Memorial. One of the biggest differences between the South Dakota-class battleships and the Iowa-class battleships is Broadway. We're standing today on Broadway on Battleship Massachusetts, which is part of the Battleship Cove collection in Fall River, Massachusetts. They invited the curatorial department from BB62 to come up and see their ship, and while we're here, we're filming some videos for you. On the Iowas, Broadway is the longest, widest passageway on the ship. It's how you access all the 5-inch magazines and all 8 engineering spaces. On the South Dakotas, it is not a straight shot between the barbettes the way it is on the Iowas. There are a couple of curves. This stretch you see behind me is probably the straightest shot. There's less subdivision here too, because the engineering main spaces are combined fire room and engine room, so there's only 4 of them instead of the 8 on the Iowas. There are a lot of differences here. The paint job, for one, is very much what it would have looked like in World War II, probably even on the on New Jersey, although she is today configured as she would have looked in the 80s. This has the overhead rail made by the Bethlehem Steel Company, painted the same color as everything else, whereas ours is bright yellow. It feels like there's more headroom in here too. The watertight doors are much smaller, and it feels like they're higher off the ground. In any event, the step to get through them is shorter. So my hips are killing me this trip from going up and down Broadway and having to high step it. Other differences is Broadway isn't quite so broad. It holds one curator. It's hard to see rows of 18-year-old boys squeezing past each other going in both directions as they try to get to their general quarter stations, or as the watches change and they're trying to get to the galley before everybody else jumps in line. The 5-inch handling rooms are very similar on Massachusetts to New Jersey. There are very small number of differences. The paint scheme, for one. The size, they feel a little bit more compressed, but not too much so. The 5-inch guns and the superstructure on Sodacs are much closer together than they are on the Iowas, simply because the superstructure is much closer together. And so the dredger hoists here also seem much closer together and much more vertical. On New Jersey, the 5-inch magazines that service 2 twin mounts each have 2 passing scuttles like this one. They're both in doors that lead to the powder magazine. On the South Dakota class battleships, there's a single door into the powder magazine and a second scuttle in the bulkhead. They have done an amazing job of restoring this space to how it would have looked with the projectiles fully stacked and the powder canisters fully stacked. From in here, gunner's mates would take shells, throw them into the dredger hoist, take powder canister into the dredger hoist so that they can move from the lower handling room here to the upper handling room 3 or 4 decks above us in the superstructure, and then from there to the gun mounts themselves. If you've watched this video on bullseyes that we shot on the Battleship New Jersey, you see what they look like in the 1980s. These big yellow squares with the information about the ship on them. Modern ships, they look pretty similar, except they're holographic, reflective, so you can see them even with the lights out. It does make you wonder why the heck they're called bullseyes. I've thrown darts before, and I ain't throwing them at yellow squares. Here is a bullseye on the South Dakota. Notice it doesn't seem so much like stenciling as somebody freehand painting it, and it is literally a bullseye in concentric rings. This isn't the same exact role as our bullseye, where every single compartment has one. This ship has little square tags that just have the compartment number painted on bulkheads in a couple of places. These are specifically for the fire plugs, places where you can plug in your firefighting equipment into the fire main. And it seems like the fire plug that was here has been cut out at some point, probably so that there can be enough room in Broadway for a person to walk down. Again, why is it so narrow here compared to in Iowa? Yeah, so, refresher on how bullseyes work. The three means we're on third deck. Broadway is on third deck. That is, the main deck is one. Second deck is where most of the berthing is. And then third deck is inside the armored citadel. This number would be your frame number. They start with frame number one at the waterline at the bow. And then they tend to be every 4 feet aft of that. Frame spacing on a battleship is 4 feet. So this line here is what the space actually shows up as on blueprints and other things. This would be the actual name of the space. B, on this ship, the ship is divided into thirds. A is everything forward of engineering, B is everything that incorporates engineering, and C is everything aft. Of course, Broadway goes over the engine rooms. 319, you're on third deck. This is the 19th space randomly designated in section B. It's just somebody with the blueprint going through. This one's 1, 2, 3, up to 19. And then the T is what type of space this is. This is a 40 millimeter ammunition trunk with a hoist to lift the clips up to a clipping room in the superstructure where the 40 millimeter guns are. Battleship New Jersey would have probably had spaces like this in her World War II and Korean War configuration, but none of them exist as such today. 40 millimeter ammo handling worked pretty similar to the 5-inch guns in that there was a magazine which would have had all of the rounds in aluminum canisters. Sometimes those rounds are stored in 4-round clips, sometimes they're stored individually. They go in their whole canister up to a hoist like this, where they're taken up to a clipping room. In the clipping room, any of the rounds which are not already on clips get loaded on, and then they're transported manually from the clipping room, sometimes through cutouts in the bulkhead, similar to the one we saw in the powder magazine for the 5-inch guns, but square instead of round, to the actual gun mounts. There would, of course, be ready service ammunition, usually around the gun tubs for the 40 millimeter guns in combat zones, typically not outside of combat zones. All of the spaces associated with the 40 millimeters have been converted to other uses on New Jersey, but it's really interesting seeing what they would have looked like on Massachusetts. If you want to see a battleship still in a World War II configuration, make sure you come out and visit Fall River, Massachusetts, and Battleship Cove. If you would like to support them and the work they're doing here, we've left some links in the description to their YouTube, Facebook, and website. If you live close enough to volunteer, you should come out and help them. They have a very young and active volunteer force here that does the bulk of the restoration work. If you can't come in person but would like to support them financially, the websites have ways for you to donate. Battleship New Jersey receives operating support from the New Jersey Department of State, and also from viewers like you. Thank you for your support. It allows us to travel and visit other museum ships like this one that have features that we can't show you anymore on our ship. We try to release multiple pieces of content every week, so remember to like, share, and subscribe so you're notified when the new stuff comes out. Thanks for watching.